close till I get up. Time is barely on our side. I don't wanna waste what's left. The storms we chase are leading us, and love is all we'll ever trust. Yeah, no, I don't wanna waste what's left. And on we'll go, through the wastelands, through the highways, till my shadow turns to sun rays. And on
my channel. So today on my Instagram, I posted on my Instagram story what sort of YouTube videos you wanted to see, and I got quite a lot of responses. And basically one of the main responses was how to deal with weight gain. I kind of knew I was going to get this response because obviously it's a massive part of anorexia recovery, and obviously I've had to deal with it. I am dealing with it. I also did a post on my Instagram. I put at the bottom that I'm going to do this YouTube video and explain all the benefits. So firstly, I am gonna say that I don't deal with weight gain that well, to be honest. I do struggle a lot, which is kind of obvious really, and it's kind of expected, because weight gain is horrible for any girl. Weight gain is horrible, and it's because it's totally against what society is all about. Like, everything's about fat loss, losing weight, everything like that. So doing the opposite is really hard, and it's something that it takes, like, you can never really get your head around it. You just kind of gotta do it. My main thing is I have a goal, and I've said this for a long time now, and I haven't actually said what my goal is. And the goal is quite controversial, and I know I'm gonna get a lot of people who aren't gonna agree with my goal, but I am so passionate about it, and I so wanna do it that, it's, to be honest, from day one I wanted to do it, and it's the reason, like, it's the first thing that I saw to be able to, like, start recovering. And I'm just gonna say it, about 9 to 12 months time, I'm not gonna set that date, but that's just a rough estimate, I am going to start a prep for a bikini competition. So a bodybuilding bikini competition. Obviously I need to gain a lot more muscle, so that's why I'm giving it at least 9 to 12 months at least to be able to gain muscle. So obviously I need to eat, I need to gain more weight to be able to do that. But that is basically my main motivation for gaining weight and to keep going, because I have this big goal to do this competition, and I want to do well in this competition. I want to win. And if I don't eat and don't gain the muscle, I can't do that competition. And the same on the other hand, like, if I went backwards and started to lose weight, I can't do that competition because I'll be too skinny and I haven't got the muscle. Yes, a prep does involve a diet phase, like be able to lean down to be able to go on stage, but that will be after I've gotten to the set weight which I need to be at to be able to gain that muscle. So that's my main motivation for gaining weight. And obviously most of you on here aren't gonna have that goal, but my point is, make a goal. So whatever it is in life, like whatever you've got, your dream job is, you wanna go traveling, you wanted to have children, you just anything in life, because when you have anorexia and when you're underweight, you're limited to so many things that you can't do so much. Like, I couldn't even walk upstairs. Like, that's just a normal human thing to do. And gaining weight makes you stronger, so you can climb stairs, you can get out of bed, you can have a job, you can go to school, you can go to university, you can drive, you can do the job you want. So there's so many benefits of gaining weight. And like, I get all these comments from people saying like, oh, you look really healthy. And oh, like, I have had some people saying, oh, you've gained weight. And at first, yes, it really does upset me because it's horrible. But I go home and after thinking about it for a while, I really think that actually, no, it's really good. I don't look like this skeleton anymore. I actually am starting to look like a normal person, like a normal woman with curves and with muscle. And it's a good thing. Like, they're not saying you've got fat. Like, they're not saying you've got fat. They're saying that you're looking healthier, you're looking better. And isn't that a positive in itself? So also, like I mentioned in my Instagram story, I can now go shopping and clothes actually fit me. So I can go into a shop and actually look at items and think, actually no, that is my size, rather than having to go to the kids section and then even wearing kids clothes is too big for you. And plus, I'm 23 years old. I don't want to be wearing kids clothes. I just don't want to be wearing kids clothes, because to be honest, you can't get nice clothes in kids. Well, except for New Look, they actually do quite nice kids clothes, but I just don't want to be wearing kids clothes anymore. It's just embarrassing, and I just want to feel like a woman. I don't want to be a kid forever. Like, that's for kids, not me. Another benefit as well is I actually have had a few boys actually being interested in me. Like, when I was, I don't want this to sound big-headed at all, like not at all, because I'm not big-headed at all, but like, you actually get boys looking at you thinking that you actually look okay, rather than looking at you thinking you look awful and ill. Like, they actually look at you thinking, oh, she actually looks quite nice. And that is very weird. Like, I've got a twin sister and she looks incredible. And I remember when I was really ill and we'd just go out into town, but like, she'd get people looking at her thinking, wow, she looks amazing. Like, she looked insane. And I would just get, like, no one would look at me, or they just look at me because I looked odd. But now I'm actually getting people looking at me in a good way, and it really does boost your confidence. Like, just not even, they don't have to say anything. It's just that look where you just know, and it's like, oh, a little confidence boost actually. And another simple thing is just being able to do daily things, like getting out of bed, going upstairs, going to work, just doing normal things and having the energy to do things. Because at one point, there was one time where I would get these real bad energy dips in the day where I'd feel sick, I couldn't hardly open my eyes, I just want to go to sleep. But I can't remember the last time I had one of those. I never get energy dips. I'm full of energy all the time, and my body is thriving from it. Like, my hands are getting better, my hair's grown, my skin is just better. Just everything just feels healthier, and you just feel nourished. And being a healthy weight is what it is, healthy. Obviously, I'm not there yet. I've still got a way to go, but I'm on that way to it, and I'm starting to feel better all the time. At the moment, I'm not happy with my body. That's gonna take a long, long time with me, because body dysmorphia is a massive part of anorexia. Having bad body image is just, it just happens, and it's just a thing I constantly deal with and battle with every single day. But I think I have good days and I have bad days, and I just try and push through it, and I just keep thinking of that end goal. That is basically what I say. Have a goal. Just have a goal, like a big goal that you wanna reach, and putting the weight on will help you achieve that goal. Because when you're healthy, you can achieve anything you want in life. Anything. You set your mind to it, you can do it. So yeah, I hope you did enjoy the video. And if you've got any more video suggestions, just let me know. And if you're new to the channel, please subscribe. And I'll catch you in the next one. Bye, guys.